The founders of our nation recognize that the freedom to make decisions and act based upon one's own conscience is a God-given right and is critical to the free exercise of religion. Nowhere is this right of conscience more important than in the arena of healthcare. Dr. David Stevens is the Chief Executive Officer of the Christian Medical and Dental Association.
Right of conscience is the ability of a healthcare professional to practice medicine according to their deeply held moral or religious views.
From the founding of our nation until now, the right of conscience for healthcare professionals has been protected by law. For example, if a doctor refused to perform a procedure that violated his conscience, such as abortion, he would be protected by law from having to do it. But that protection is now threatened, both from activist groups like the ACLU and the Obama administration.
Because of these laws, you think, why do we have a right of conscience issue? Well, the problem is none of the laws have any teeth in them. There's no enforcement provision. There's no ability of a healthcare professional to bring a private right of action, a suit against someone for discrimination. And unfortunately, discrimination is rampant in healthcare at this time.
There are 46 states that have conscience protection laws for healthcare providers. Those would be abolished as well. That means that if an individual goes to get contraception, or if a woman goes to a hospital and a doctor says, well, it's against my conscience to perform an abortion, they will be forced to do it because there are no laws restricting them now.
Now, what's very frightening right now is that the ACLU and other groups are trying to literally force crisis pregnancy centers to refer women for abortions and to have Christian hospitals and Catholic hospitals to perform abortions. They want to force the unconscionable for us to go against a most sacred tenet of our faith, that life is sacred. They want us to kill. They want us to force us to kill children or give up Christian hospital work. It's just outrageous.
The result is that medical students and doctors are being forced to make hard decisions about their careers. Discrimination against medical students has been in place for quite some time now in Canada.
When did it start exactly?
About a week ago.
A case in point is Dr. Lisa Lambert, who is now a general practitioner in Florida. Dr. Lambert came to a rude awakening as a medical student in Canada when she was called in to assist a doctor during her residency.
When I was an intern, I had to go through a rotation where we had to participate with the surgeons who were doing the abortions, and some of the students were traumatized by it, and when it was my turn to be involved, it was a very horrible experience. They had a transparent plastic tube, and we had to look at all the parts go by to make sure that all the baby, the arms and the feet and the legs, that everything, the baby was all out of the uterus. I had nightmares every night. I was for months without being able to eat any meat or to even see any meat. Just at night, I couldn't sleep.
Experiences like Dr. Lambert's are now taking place all over America. A survey of healthcare professionals indicated 23% say they've been discriminated against in their medical education or career because of their beliefs. And 40% say they've been pressured to perform a medical function against their convictions. If doctors or nurses can be threatened, so can citizens in general.
If they can walk into a doctor's office or force a nurse or a pharmacist to violate their conscience, then no one's conscience protections were worth anything in this country. They can walk into your place of business. They can walk into your home and tell you what you have to believe and what you have to do. To the degree that the state demands that you surrender your conscience to them, and to other words, only do things that are sanctioned by the state, the government becomes totalitarian. It becomes a dictatorship, because if we don't have right of conscience on the abortion issue, what's going to happen at the end of life? You know, the cheapest form of health care at the end of life when you're terminally ill is a handful of lethal pills costing less than $50 versus tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands of dollars for good end of life care. And a health care system increasingly challenged by the bottom line. I want a doctor who's going to protect me at the end of life and not some bureaucrat who's going to say, hey, listen, doctor, you just need to not give them this medicine or encourage them to do the right thing and get out of the way so they don't eat up valuable health care resources.
For Christians and non-Christians, doctors and general citizens, this is an issue that impacts everyone.
This is one of our most basic freedoms, and if we don't protect it, if we let this line fall, whether you're a healthcare professional or not, every single American citizen is in danger. This is not the America that we knew. This is an America that we'll be afraid to live in.